in October and November, order number one is commence the CAO candidate evaluation. Of course, we would need to meet with Sam Cates to discuss transition matters. Swearing in ceremonies on November 4th. I would post my meeting schedules online very soon after election. I want Winnipeggers to know early on that there would really be a change in tone, especially in the culture of openness and transparency at City Hall. And one of the ways that we'll be able to do that is to start mapping out very early who I'm meeting with and what I'm doing on a day-to-day basis. Of course, meeting with the acting CAO and senior staff, firstly to get a briefing on the current state of the city as well as a budget. Review the senior administrative staff positions. There will be changes at City Hall, and we need to bring in some fresh air, some fresh ideas, and some fresh blood at City Hall, starting with the mayor, as well as with some of our senior staff. We'll lay the groundwork for the foundation of the repairing our badly needed and aging infrastructure. So soon after being elected, we'll be meeting with not only senior administrative staff, but also industry officials. We'll obviously do the organizational council meeting, including electing and appointing members of EPC and special committees, meeting with the acting CAO, and of course, meeting with the Premier, Minister Kevin Chief, and our senior federal minister on Winnipeg's fair share, as well as the Build Winnipeg partnership. December would be hosting our Winnipeg review session for council and senior administration and planning staff, especially for our new council members. There is going to be some turnover. I want to ensure that they've all had an opportunity to review and understand the Our Winnipeg plan, which I'm committed to, as well as I would be meeting with post-secondary institutions. Some of the council motions that we would want to get introduced as soon as possible would include, among other things, establishing an Office of Public Engagement, abolishing the Office of Policy, Development and Communications, amending the Councillor's Representation Allowance Fund policy, adopting the United Way's plan to end homelessness, establishing Executive Council, formerly Executive Policy Secretariat, creating the volunteer web hub for community centres, as well as including the artistic component in construction projects. Well, no one who's running, including Judy, has served as mayor. So there is going to be some transition for anybody that takes a position. But no one that's running has served as mayor. The difference that I have is I've actually been in a position of accountability. I've been in a position where the buck stops with me and where I have to demonstrate value for stakeholders. You know, it's very different than just being an opposition critic.